The idea that you can run something on a community-built network makes everything cheaper. So now you're talking about $20 cell phone plans, because you're not talking about one large centralized organization that has to think about the real estate, the operations, the upkeep, the headcount. With Helium, it's a community that's leveraging what they already have as far as locations and hardware that's just going to continue to come down in cost over time.
I'm Noah Prince, and I'm the head of protocol engineering at Helium Foundation.
I'm Abhay Kumar. I'm the CEO of the Helium Foundation.
I'm Scott Siegel. I'm COO of the Helium Foundation.
Hey, Helium's building wireless networks. The idea of how do you make sure that any person or anything can be connected to the internet around the world? How do you make sure that rural areas, underserved urban areas can have that type of connectivity and that anybody can be an infrastructure provider and get rewarded for it? Pretty aspirational and amazing thing to bring to the world.
Helium is actually one of the easier blockchain use cases to describe because there's actual physical hardware on the ground. So there are two networks. There's a 5G network and there's an IoT network. The IoT network is for sensors, package tracking, things like that. Basically, anybody can become a cell phone tower. They can put up a hotspot in their house and then people walking around can use it.
The real promise of the Internet of Things can only really be achieved if you have a network that's available everywhere you go. But you always hit this cost problem. Like, how do I deploy $50, $100 sensors that I then have to pay $10 a month to keep operating and do that 100,000 times to get the kind of scale that I would need to be able to make those kinds of actionable insights?
There really are three kinds of users: the people creating coverage, the people that are building businesses based on the existence of that coverage, and then there are the people that just want coverage. Ultimately, Helium is a network that aligns the incentives between the people that actually want to be able to connect and the people that are able to provide a connectivity.
If I'm going to go and put a hotspot up in my house, I'm paying electricity for it, I'm paying for the internet that's backing it. I need some incentive to do this. And so you're using a token to solve this bootstrapping problem where the first person who puts up a hotspot is compensated for it.
You're coordinating work in the physical world at a large scale, and token incentives help to solve for that, because to try to process this over traditional payment rails, it's not feasible. It only works with blockchain technology, and at that kind of speed and that kind of scale, Solana's a natural fit for that.
Building the world's largest wireless network is a hard enough problem as it is. I don't need a blockchain that's getting in my way. And so Solana doesn't. We took an entire blockchain and then shoved it into Solana, and it was fine.
As the Helium network grows, we need the blockchain that's underlying to also grow with it. And Solana is the only real option for something like that.
And when we're thinking about not just the coordination and the scalability, but what does that experience look like for the average user? It needs to be intuitive, it needs to be fast, it needs to be simple. And Solana truly is the only blockchain that can power those types of interfaces.
It's already proven itself so far with a tremendous amount of scale, and we see that it'll grow along with us to continue to support the scale of not just Helium, but several other applications that are really only possible at human scale on a network like Solana.